Now we move on to the next session about inverters, which is definitely the heart of every solar PV system. And ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Mr. Hani Raja, Head Sales India for Solace Technologies, Mr. Rauf Javed, Country Head of Chind Power, Mr. Kishore Sharma, GM Marketing, NJ Team Power Technologies, Mr. Vikram Hans, Managing Director from Delta Power, as our session chair and moderator. Mr. Pradeep Menon, Head Technical and Strategy Renewables from Havells India. Mr. Shantanu Sirsat, Product Manager from Growatt New Energies. And Mr. Namit Aneja, Key Account Manager from SunGrow India.
The panel with me, and to set the ball rolling, I would just like to make a single point reference here. Today, besides the price point, which has been talked about since morning, I'm sure, and in the previous panel also, besides the price point, how much juice can I get out of the system? I think that is the most important selling point that anyone would try to use, whether he tries to sell it using data, empirical data, or reference data from his existing sites, or PVsyst, of course, is one way of doing it. And in addition to all this, on topping all this, he could talk about technology. So now I have a question which I will throw up to the people on my right. I'll throw it up to you guys first. My question is that when I look at the specifications of inverters, string inverters specifically, three-phase string inverters of similar ratings, and I look at the efficiencies that are given and the overload capacities that are given, they are roughly the same. They are roughly the same across brands. There's a very marginal difference. But if I would like to also compare the same, the gentleman in the previous panel, he made a very important point. Remember this gentleman from SMA? He said, I'm willing to now offer 25-year warranty. So that ensures that, number one, I'm confident about my product. Number two, you as a customer, you'll get more juice out of it for the next 25 years. So I would like to hear from this side of the panel. What? And let's be quick. We have a target, guys. Okay, please cooperate. We want to close this by 5 o'clock, right?
Yeah. So as sir said, that a person from SMA said that they are offering 25 years of extended warranty. So I think it is really important. On behalf of SunGrow, I would like to say that be it central inverters or string inverters, we have a bucket full of all the required different covering different applications. So we are offering extended warranty up to 25 years as well, 5 years of standard and standard warranty, and extended 20 years of further warranty. So the focus is on quality and innovation. From SunGrow's perspective, definitely, the founder itself is a PhD professor. So he started the company with the idea of innovation and how he can technologically contribute to the renewable segment. And we have been leading the solar inverter segment and for more than 21 years now. In terms of technology, I would say that, as you said, that all the different string inverters of different brands have almost the same efficiencies on paper and how we differ from product to product. So I can speak about my product that what we offer is that apart from the efficiency that we declare at 50 degrees Celsius, what we provide is 15% extra AC output at 45 degrees Celsius and 25% extra AC output at 30 degrees Celsius. Our new product, 200 kilowatt string inverters, have all these features. So this is one thing I think what we focus on, not only keeping the standard parameters, but also innovating and focusing, because actually the temperature, average temperature at Indian site is around 35 to 45. So we want to focus that during those temperatures, maximum operating times, how the inverter or a product is operating. So this is
Namit, is this also related to the humidity conditions?
Yes, yes, okay. Yeah.
As he said that, yes, most of the inverter manufacturing is having the same specs that if you will compare. But along with the specs, it is also a part of the after-sales service that we are providing. basically the BOM or the materials that we are using, or the component levels that we are using for basically the conversion purpose, or the capacitors, those also plays a very important role. Because as we are saying that a standard warranty of 5 years or 7 years for any particular inverter brand, but if when we are claiming that we are extending that same warranty up to 20 years or 25 years, that much confidence we should also have when we are designing some sort of product. So the components also play a very vital role in this particular area. So the BOM that is used for the inverter side, it also plays a very important role.
See, I would just like to tell you that at Havells, you know, we went to improve the efficiency and yield of any system. We adopted a different technology. We actually went in with inverters and the optimizer-based technology, where the MPPT was at the module level. We have both the ranges of technologies. We have the standard string inverters, which we have displayed outside. But 2 years ago, when we got into the business, you know, we partnered with SolarEdge. And you know, we brought the module level power electronics based technology to India. Today we have more than about 800 odd installations across the country, and almost 50 megawatts of deployment of this technology. This is definitely different from all other inverter technologies, in the sense that in India the biggest challenge of getting improved yield comes from the O&M side, because of our environment and other issues, and module mismatch and partial shading. And especially as the rooftop industry picked up compared to the ground mount, the problem of partial shading, chimneys, other factors, maintenance, this caused system efficiencies to drop sharply, irrespective however good your inverter might be. So that is where the role of the optimizer based at the module level really helped, because at least it ensured that each PV module performs at its peak of the best and not affected by any other module in the stream. So this is something we have deployed very successfully, and we have found that very good results. Today we have almost about 700 reference sites, and we have been collating the data. In terms of why we keep both the technologies is that, I would say that cost in India is definitely a factor for the customers as well. So what we do is we analyze a particular site. We deploy the module level power electronics based technology in sites where we feel the need and the customer will benefit by paying that extra price. And wherever, if it's a good site and the site conditions are good, we go with the standard string inverter technology. So it's basically based on a kind of an advisory, what we tell our partners. And we have a backup design engineering team, which helps and supports this thing.
Thank you, Pradeep. I'll come back to you on this, because what you're saying now, to improve the yield, you have one layer of technology as a string inverter, and on top of that you're adding the optimizer. I'll come back to you on this with probably another question. To my friends on the left, now I have another aspect of string inverters, which is that traditionally, hello, from the time immemorial, since I have been seeing the grid tie technology around, we've always been talking about 1:1 ratio, DC and the inverter capacity. It's only recently that some of us, while selling, we've been telling the industrial customers, especially, that you could overload your inverters by 20%, 25%. I have overloaded inverters by 30%. In an industrial setup, I've overloaded them by 30% also. And the yield has come out to be better. But then, to my mind, does this apply to all conditions, all operating conditions, or does this apply to only those conditions where I would have the peak output from the DC side happening in only 1 hour or 2 hours? I mean, I would like to have your comments and your insight into this, because I'm a big promoter of this kind of an aspect. And secondly, I would also like to know that, what is the ratio of your sales that happens in the 1:1 market and overloading condition?
Yeah, good evening to everyone. So just to touch upon the first point which you mentioned to the right of ours, about the efficiency, about the warranties that the companies are providing, and how to back them up. Yes, sure. So we from NG team see this aspect to twofold. One of them being the inverter designed environment, taking care of the environment, both the physical environment, which is the temperature and the humidity, and also the grid environment, because grid environment is changing every day now with more and more renewables entering into the grid space. So the inverter has to be designed to consider more and more fluctuations and considering the reactive power that is going to be fed to the grid and the what challenges renewables are going to bring. So one is the design aspect, the inverter should be ready with that. Another aspect is the infrastructure that the inverter companies should be prepared with before offering such kind of efficiency warranties. So in NG team also, we are prepared from the point of view of the service infrastructure to provide standard warranties of 5 years and up to 25 years the extended warranty. Now coming to the point of overloading, so which has been a very talked about point like since the inception of solar industry. So right now, if you talk about from our customers, if you talk about the ratio, mostly the 1:1 ratio has been followed by the government customers, those who are not ready to take the risk of loading the inverters more to gain more energy. And most of the private, I would say these days, the RESCO players, they want to take out, like you said, the word, they take out more and more juice out of the system. So we see that 25% is the trend in rooftop industry. And if you go to the utility scale, we are bidding in some of the developers' bids where the loading is up to 50%. 50 in utility scale. And this is not very new to me, to NG team, but to all the utility scale suppliers.
Yeah, which rating of inverters would you load 50% extra? Which rating of inverters?
So
not all.
No, I think from the aspects of the overloading, the rating of the inverter will not matter much, because one aspect is the higher generation or the higher power that the inverters have at lower temperatures, which helps in reducing the clipping loss, because eventually clipping is going to happen if you are loading the inverter by 50%, any inverter, not only NG team, any inverter. But how the inverter design is prepared for higher loadings, one aspect is higher generation, higher loadings or the higher power at lower temperature. Another aspect is at what temperature will the inverter start derating. So like 50 degrees Celsius is now the general trend, and those who are not rating their inverters at 50 degrees Celsius, they are actually losing on the generation, or the clipping loss is more for them. So this is one, these are the two aspects. And one thing that eventually will happen with all the inverters when the loading is more, that your inverter is going to be at its peak power for more number of hours, which means it will be strained more. So the inverter should be tested and designed, the bill of material of the inverter should be considering this kind of experiencing the peaks for say 5 hours in a day, as compared to like the rooftop plants where the 1:1 ratio is there, where the peak reaches say for 15 minutes only. So I think this is the aspect where in the design point of view, this has to be taken care of. So this is the aspect.
Over a period of time, what has happened now in Indian scenario, people are trying to ask for those things which have not been tried and tested anywhere in the world. Now, for instance, one of these is DC-AC ratio. So because we come from a company, Chint Power, which exports components to more than 140 countries. And in some of the countries, we are leaders, basically. And when we go and ask our R&D guys, okay, maybe for instance, the question that you have asked, what are the ratings of inverters that can be overloaded to 50%? More or less, all the inverters can be loaded in a range from 30% to 50% overloading. Because now if you're talking about central inverters, the nomenclature is such that if I'm talking about a 3.125 machine, which is a standard machine right now, most of the suppliers are giving you 3.125. So what happens in that scenario, this 3.125 machine has a safety factor, which is tested in labs. So now what we simulate in labs and what we actually have on ground, there's a huge variation. And also when you touched upon a point that all the inverters look identical on data sheets, yes, they look identical on data sheets. And it's a very difficult task for companies to actually see a data sheet and choose a good one from the bad one. But now, when the industry is, we are like about, now if you want to say that 28 0.5 gigawatts of hearts are still beating in India, because that's what the session says. Because this is the heart, inverter is the heart of the system. But if it was the heart of the system, people would not be dealing with inverters like this, how they are dealing. So this is something, you know, people have to understand. Though we are a mature market, I would not still say that we are a mature market. We are evaluating, we are evolving, and we are 30 gigawatt market. But having said all of this, this AC-DC ratio, now going one step forward, you are talking about the DC side. There are people who are talking about AC side overloading.
Yeah, I would like to know
about. Yes. So now what happens, this is like you sending your child, a child who's studying in class grade 3. You tell him, okay, out of 6 periods of your regular third grade, why don't you switch to 2 classes of grade 5th maths? So this is the kind of exposure, or this is the kind of this is the kind of exposure which we are getting into. You are making your inverter work more. You're making it work harder. So without realizing that, it will have an impact on the life cycle of the components. Though your inverters are designed, they have a safety factor, and those safety margins are always kept in mind by all these companies. So it's not that your inverter, but now when we say that we are going to give you a 5 years warranty, so electronics are electronics, they're bound to fail. But there is a mean time between failure of the components. There's a lifetime of the components. So when we go and tell these, now Chint has an advantage that most of the electronics come from same staple. We manufacture almost 60% of the component in-house, barring few like the IGBT or maybe the other compact like contactors or sensors, but most of the components come in-house, and we have the flexibility, I would say, that yes, we can guarantee them 7 years warranty rather than a 5 years warranty, because we know that our products could be tested. But in Indian scenario, what is happening now is if we are putting so much of stress on our electronics and we want them to perform for 25 years, then these things have to be incorporated now. Because it's not the, because now, unfortunately, people who are in the manufacturing business, they want to make quick gains. So I would not like to touch upon this point, but I have to. If you look at the history of inverter suppliers, there have been very big suppliers coming in, ruling the roost, disappearing. Next year, you have one more company coming in, conquering the market, disappearing. So very important is not only the component suppliers, but also a company which is here to stay, because you have to stay, you have to earn on the projects, and you have to earn for 25 years. Or if some people have a mindset of 7 years, then it's a different issue. But having said this, yes, all the inverter suppliers are capable of overloading systems of 50% on the DC side, as well as 10% on the AC side. But that is not what should be a standard practice. But yes, the tariffs, the way tariffs are falling down, 2 rupees, four paisa, or 2 rupees, 40 paisa, or whatever, we still have to be a little more wise in handling with the hearts, what you call the inverters.